This is Kurt Heisinger, accounting professor at Sierra College and author of Managerial Accounting. This video describes two different approaches to pricing products. The first one that we will talk about is the cost plus pricing approach. That's what you see on this slide. And then the second one that we'll talk about in a minute is target costing. With cost plus pricing, this is most useful. It's used by many different companies, but it's most useful for companies that produce custom products where it might be difficult to determine the market value of our product. For example, we might be a jetliner producer. We might be Boeing, and we produce jetliners for companies such as United Airlines. In establishing the price, we could first start by looking at the cost that it are incurred to produce those jetliners. From there, we would add a certain profit percentage to establish the price. So if it costs, say, $100 million to produce a jetliner, making up numbers here, but we'll use a nice round number, $100 million, and we're Boeing and we'd like to mark it up 20%, then we would simply take $100 million times 20%. And I'll move this slide up a little bit so I have more room. We'll take the $100 million times the 20%, and that gives us the markup, which would be $20 million. And therefore, the price would be the $100 million plus the $20 million, or the price, in this example, would be $120 million. So we simply take the original cost that it takes to manufacture the product, in this example, $100 million, add whatever our desired profit percentage is, 20% in this example, or $20 million, and that gives us the price. In this example, $120 million. Another approach to pricing is an approach called target costing. And this is an interesting approach. It's very, very useful for manufacturing companies in that instead of producing a product, determining the cost of that product, and then pushing it onto the consumer at some price we think is reasonable, we're going to start with the price and then back into the cost. So the first step that you see here, step one, is to design a product that provides the features and the price demanded by the customers. So we're going to take a look at putting together a product that has features that the customers want and then make sure that we establish a price that is also a price that customers are willing to pay. I'll use the example of a laser printer. Let's say that we've got a laser printer. It's got everything that our customers want, the features that they want, and we've determined that customers are willing to pay $240 for this laser printer that we would like to produce. As a company, we've determined that our desired profit is 40% of the sales price. What that means then with this product is we're going to take $240, that's our sales price, times 40%, and that's going to give us our desired profit of $96. Next, we're going to derive the target cost by subtracting the desired profit, which we figured out on the previous slide, of $96, from the desired price of $240. So we're going to take $240 minus the $96 in desired profit, and that tells us that our target cost in manufacturing the laser printer is $144. So again, that is our target cost. The next step then is to engineer the product to achieve that target cost. So we're going to go to our engineers and say, we've got this laser printer, we know we've got customers who will buy it for $240, and if we can produce it for $144, then we will make that desired profit of $96. And it's up then to the company to come up with a way to produce that product for the target cost that we've established in step three. And if for some reason we can't do that, then we start over. We go back to step one and we're going to reevaluate the features and the price and take a look at whether this product is viable or not. So this is called target costing.